way out. Once upon a time, there was a little engine called Edward. He lived in a shed with five other engines. They were all bigger than Edward and boasted about it.
"The driver won't choose you again," they said. "He wants big, strong engines like us."
Edward had not been out for a long time. He began to feel sad. Just then, the driver and fireman came to start work. The driver looked at Edward. "Why, you sad?" he said. "Would you like to come out today?" "Oh, yes, please," said Edward. So the fireman lit his fire and made a nice lot of steam. And the driver pulled the throttle, and Edward puffed happily away.
"Peep, peep,"
he said. "Look at me now." The other engines were very cross at being left behind.
Away Edward went to get some coaches. "Be careful, Edward," they said. "Don't bump the bangles of the other engines, do."
So Edward bumpered up to the coast very gently, and the shunter fastened the cover.
"Thank you, Edward. That was kind. We're glad you're taking us today."
Station where people were waiting.
"Beep, beep!"
he whistled. "Get in quickly, please." So the people got in quickly, the shunter banged the doors, and Edward made happily through the dark wing with a green flag. But there was no green flag, no guard.
"Beep, beep!"
Edward whistled anxiously.
"Where is the guard?"
"Have you seen the guard?" the driver asked the station master. "No," he said. Then they asked the porter. "Have you seen the guard?" "Yes, last night," he said. Edward was getting anxious.
"Beep, beep, beep, beep. Are we ever going to start?"
Just then, a little boy shouted, "Here he comes!" And there was the guard, running towards the station with his flags in one hand and a sandwich in the other. Without further hesitation, the guard blew his whistle, waved his green flag, and Edward puffed happily away. Edward did have a lovely day. He saw a lot of people waving at him and met a lot of old friends at all the stations. Edward did so well that the driver and fireman promised to take him out again tomorrow.
"I'm going out again tomorrow," Edward said happily. "What do you think of that?"
But he didn't hear what the others thought. He was so tired and happy that he fell asleep at once.